In this video, I'm sharing my top 5 Adobe AI features from 2024 that you should be using in 2025. Stick around to see which one takes the number one spot.
Studio Shepherd.
At number 5, we have the new Lens Blur feature in Adobe Photoshop. This transforms your images into professional-looking photographs. Let me show you how. So in Photoshop, we want to start by switching to Camera Raw. You can do this by going up to Filter and selecting the Camera Raw filter. Now in the right-hand panel here, scroll down until you find Lens Blur and then tick Apply. The AI-powered feature will automatically detect the subject and apply a natural blur. Now you can adjust the blur amount slider to increase the intensity of the blur. And you can see we have these different bokeh types here to choose from. Now if you hover over them, you can see what lens would have generally been used to create this effect. So select one that you like. And you can even boost the bokeh with this slider here. Now, if you want to adjust the focus range, you can do that with this slider. So first, select the visualize depth. And what this will show is the warm and yellow tones reflect what's in focus, and the cool blue tones are what's out of focus. And when we adjust the slider, you can see the white symbolizes what's in focus. So you can see it shifting to the background. Now you can use this target icon here and select anywhere on your image to make that area in focus, or simply select this little person here to snap to your subject. Now under this refinement dropdown is where you can make any adjustments to your focus range. So for example, this guy here, I want to be a little bit more blurred out. So to do that, I'm going to select blur, and here I'm going to bump my blur amount up to full. You can adjust your brush size and the feather or the softness of your brush and the flow, which is the intensity of your brush. And then I can simply brush them out. So it's something like this. And now you can see I can still make changes here by adjusting the slider. So I'm going to have it set to something like this. And when you're happy, you can click this plus button to lock it in. This means you can now work on other areas separately and adjust the blur amount without adjusting your previous changes. If you want to reset them, simply hit this icon here. Now deselect visualize depth to see what your image is looking like. So I'm going to make some final tweaks to get that look that I'm going for. And then when you're happy, click OK. And there you have it. A quick and easy way to create a realistic lens blur in Photoshop. Coming in at number 4 is Photoshop's new Remove Distractions feature. This powerful tool effortlessly removes unwanted people from your background or messy cables from your images. Let's have a look. So in Photoshop, make sure you're using the latest version, which is 26.0. And I have my image open, and as you can see, we have some people in the background that we want to remove. So under layers, select your image and then make sure your image is unlocked. And now go over and select the remove tool. And you'll find this new button up here called find distractions. Now we can click this and then select people. And as you can see, it's selected all the people in the background. After that, simply hit this tick. And what it's going to do is remove those people and use generative AI to fill in the gaps. And just like that, no more people in the background. Now in this next example, we have this image of people working at a desk, and we want to remove all of these messy cables. So following the same steps, go over and select the remove tool, go up to find distractions, and select wires and cables. And just like that, it's removed all of the wires from the image. Now you can see it hasn't done a perfect job, but we can go in with the remove tool and simply highlight some of these areas that we want to touch up. And that's how to use the new Find Distractions tool in Adobe Photoshop. At number three is the Sketch to Vector tool in Illustrator that turns your basic drawings into high quality vectors. Let's take a look. So in Adobe Illustrator, I'm using the latest version 28.6 or above. And I've already drawn the outline, the unicorn that I want to create. And you can do this by using the pencil tool and set the stroke to black. And then simply draw your picture. So once you've done that, we want to go up to Window and make sure Contextual Taskbar is selected. Now select your drawing and then click Gen Shape Fill. And I'm going to type in Unicorn, as that's what I want to create. And then I'm going to adjust the settings by clicking this cog. And here we can adjust the shape strength, which adjusts how closely the variation matches the shape. And the detail, which obviously adjusts the level of detail. So I'm going to leave these in the middle. And then under Effects, I'm going to select Minimalism. But you can select any one of these effects. And then I'm going to hit Generate. And as you can see, it's turned our initial sketch into this high quality vector. So here's a diagram I created that shows how the vector will look as you adjust the detail slider. So from the midpoint and lower is going to be perfect for creating logo ideas. And then anywhere up is going to create this more high quality detailed vector. And that's how you can turn a basic sketch into a high quality vector in just one click using Adobe Illustrator. At number two is the generative fill in Photoshop that can turn any image into a realistic painting. Let's check it out. So with your image open in Photoshop, we're going to start by creating a quick mask. And so you can do that by clicking this button down here under your colors. And we're going to double click our foreground color. And we're going to change the brightness here. So currently it's set to 100%. And so the greater the value, the stronger the effect will be. So I'm going to change this to 40, which seems to be the sweet spot. And then press OK. Now go up to Edit, down to Fill. Make sure Contents is set to foreground color. And then press OK. Now you should see this red, which indicates the masked area. Now after that, we can exit our quick mask by hitting this button again. Now go up to Window and make sure you've selected Contextual Taskbar. When this has appeared, click Generative Fill and we're going to type in the prompt oil painting. And then press Generate. And now under Properties, you'll get three variations to choose from. And so I really like the look of this one here, but if you don't, you can click Generate again to create three more variations. And that's how to turn any image into an oil painting using generative AI in Photoshop. And finally, at number one, we have this stunning 3D calligraphic text effect created using Adobe Illustrator and Firefly. Let's jump in and see how it's done. So in Adobe Illustrator, I've started by hand drawing my calligraphic text. And I've done that using the pencil tool. So once you've drawn your text, the next thing that we want to do is give it a 3D look. So to do this, I'm going to select the ellipse tool. And while holding shift, I'm going to draw one circle. And then if we open the gradient over here and make sure your fill is selected, we can click this gradient slider here to apply it to our shape. Now I'm going to change the angle to negative 90. And then with your circle selected, I'm just going to hold Alt, click and drag, and that's going to make a copy. Now selecting our two shapes, we can go up to Object, Blend, Make. Now to adjust this, we can double click the Blend tool over here. It's going to bring up some options. And I'm just going to change the spacing to specified steps. And I'm going to set this to the max of 1000. So once you've created that, select your shape and your text. And go up to Object, down to blend again, and we're going to click replace spline. And that's going to apply this 3D look to our text. Now, once you've done that, simply export it as a JPEG, and then we'll jump across to Adobe Firefly. So in Adobe Firefly, open the text to image generator, and then in the prompt description, type floating coiled rope, comma, light brown background. And then after that, we're going to click generate. And that's going to generate 4 variations for us to choose from. Now pick one that you like. This one here is working quite well, so you can download that to make a copy. But what we're going to do is click this pencil icon here and use this as our style reference. After that, we're going to adjust a couple settings on the left panel here. We're going to change the aspect ratio to 16:9. Have content type set to photo, turning auto off. I'm going to select hyper realistic in effects and change the lighting to studio light. After that, we can go up to the structure reference, click this icon, and select the text that we created earlier. Click continue here. And now we're just going to bump up the strength slider to full and make sure your styles are around the midpoint here. Once you've done all that, click generate. And that's going to apply the material that we created to our text. Now you can repeat those same steps and play around with different prompts to create different materials for your text. Here's a few examples that I'll leave in the description below for you to play with. And that's my top 5 Adobe AI features of 2024. Be sure to like and subscribe for more.